Hey!
Hello.
Welcome to episode 5 of Sketchbook Club Online.
You're invited to draw along with us.
Yeah, go get some paper and some pens. Today we are drawing each other. So I'm drawing Helen.
I'm drawing Nathan.
And I'm drawing Lize.
But we're gonna use each other's Instagram selfies.
Yeah.
So should we show what selfies we're using?
Yes.
Okay, I'll go first.
Okay.
So I'm using this picture of Helen. Isn't she beautiful?
No, stop.
So I'm gonna paint Helen as well.
I'm going to use this amazing picture of Nathan, looking beautiful.
So beautiful. Mm-hmm.
I think I'm just gonna do some quick sketches and maybe do some pen over the top.
And then I'm going to do this effervescent picture of Lize.
Effervescent.
With my dog. Let's see.
I'm gonna do pen and pencil and paper.
Cool, pencil and paper. I'm using a different sketchbook today. It has my name on. So good.
It makes me feel so fun. Yeah. Put her name on it.
Yeah. It's from Mossery and Co. And they sent me this one, so
it's so pretty.
It needed its debut. I mostly use it for planning and sketching, but it's got really nice multimedia paper to paint in, so that will be nice.
Where Helen lives today.
Yeah. And I'm gonna sketch out as well and then paint in gouache.
Again.
With your ready-made palettes.
With my ready-made palettes.
Yes.
That I made yesterday.
Nice.
We thought, for our topic of discussion, because we enjoyed that last week, having something else to talk about, we talk about art risks and stuff, because I appreciate other people talking about that.
Risks.
In art.
It's really hard to say.
Risky risks.
Yeah. Gotta make sure I do your brows justice. Get your cheekbones in.
I'm going stylized. I'm going with my style.
I'm not really sure what I'm going for. How are you finding it?
It's a challenge because I want to capture Lize, but also
not.
it's the style again. I want it to be.
Oh right, yeah.
Styled. Just right.
It doesn't really look like the picture, but this is my sketch. So I'm gonna paint it, and it's not gonna look anything like the selfie I'm using, but it's got the elements, it's the same hat, same parting.
The essence of Helen.
Yes. Yeah. I don't know what colors to do. I might do you all in blues.
Ooh.
So I've got this nice blue corner.
Sounds nice.
So, risks.
Risks.
We felt like risks was a good topic because we've all faced quite a few in our art jobs, and it's always scary. Mm. But I find it comforting knowing that other people have taken the risks and come out okay. And it's definitely something Laura has instilled in me.
Yeah.
She's always been you just do it and then make it work. And you can't go anywhere if you don't take risks.
Yes.
Yeah, definitely. Because I guess you took quite a big risk with bringing Laura in.
Yeah, definitely.
It's a whole new venture.
Yeah, looking back, it wasn't a risk at all.
Yeah.
Because I had an idea and she turned it into a job. But we could have... I asked her to work with me. Having spent less than a few hours in her company. So we could have just hated each other.
Yeah.
That was a risk in itself.
Yeah, that's very true.
But we got on. We went and met for coffee, and I told her about it and said I needed help. And I just judged it on that meeting. It's kind of like an interview, I guess.
And it all worked out really well.
It did. It paid off. It's now a job, which it wouldn't have been without her. And moving into a studio as well is a massive risk, because when we've just moved into a studio now, but we have been in one for the past year. Before that, when Laura first joined, we were working in my spare room, and I was not for the studio. It was too scary.
You didn't want the change, did you?
I hate change.
Yeah.
So she kind of pushed it. But it's
good. Looking back, I can't believe I was against it, to be honest. What an idiot.
When, as an artist, do you think it's the right time to have your own studio opposed to working from home?
That's a good question.
Yeah, I think everybody is different, and you have to just be honest with yourself about how much you're getting done at home.
Mm.
And it's quite easy to lie to yourself and be like, oh no, I worked 8 hours today, when actually you spent 2 making lunch, and then like had a slow morning and doing household chores.
Yeah.
And I kind of realised, like, I wasn't doing a full day here, obviously, because it's my house. But yeah, I know a lot of people who can work from home and do it well.
Yeah. It must be challenging to work from home.
It's just the change of scenery.
Yeah.
And I'm a lazy person, so if I don't have to go outside, I won't.
Yeah.
So that made it tough. Because I would just spend all day working. And then not leave the house, and they'll be like, why do I feel weird? What's up? But when I do a day at the studio and then come back, I just feel so much more like, I don't know, positive about the day I've had.
Yeah.
And you don't beat yourself up for not doing enough because you're at home, like you can't do any more.
Yeah. I tend to feel, if I've stayed in for a few days, painting or otherwise, and then I actually go out into the world and I see my friends, I always feel like I forget how to talk to people.
Oh yeah, definitely. Mm.
Yeah. So I guess having a studio and going out and seeing people, you feel more connected.
Yeah, and it makes it like feel like a job as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Because before we got the studio, I just felt a bit like I was like, I don't know, like it was just a hobby.
Mm.
And I was like kidding myself that it was ever going to be a job.
Look at you.
Yeah,
it's amazing.
It is.
I'm making you look quite feminine here, aren't I? I've like softened your jaw.
Oh, I don't think that's a hard job.
I'm really digging you with blue hair, Helen.
Maybe I should dye my hair blue.
I think you should totally dye your hair blue.
I concur.
I thought you were going to say I couldn't care.
No,
I couldn't care.
I'm a huge advocate of blue hair. Yeah.
So what are some risks you two have taken?
You can go first.
Non-business.
I feel like I need to think about this.
Okay. I've taken risks in... I had a job coming straight from uni, which I've spoken about. In the previous videos, but so I feel like it was a risk leaving, maybe leaving a job.
Mm.
But I think it paid off. Like I knew it would.
It's always a risk, though, right?
Yeah,
always.
I think it was a financial risk.
Yeah.
But it was one I was willing to take.
Mm.
I think sometimes it's the whole idea of having the plan but like then following through with that plan
is hard.
Yeah, it can be, and because it's because of the potential risks, you can just falter back and just second guess yourself a lot.
Even knowing before Sketchbook Club, I was like kind of a freelance illustrator, but not really. Even knowing what jobs to take is kind of risky.
Mm.
And knowing like what will pay off, especially because your time is so valuable.
Mm.
And underselling yourself, like everybody does that in the beginning, but knowing what jobs are going to be worth underselling yourself for.
Mm.
I think, and like who to support and work with.
Yeah.
So I was lucky, a lot of the works I got were through people I'd met from art fairs and stuff. So even if they couldn't pay, I wanted to support them, and it turned out to be really good, like name recognition for mm-hmm. me, because I've worked with them. But there are a lot that I've done that nothing came from, and it was all just a massive waste of time.
Yeah.
And that can be quite off-putting.
So as a freelance artist, where did you begin?
I kind of just wanted to make my own stuff. kind of like you now, Helen. Mm. Like, I just wanted to make money from making things that I wanted to make.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I was quite stubborn, but I was really into comics when I first started. So I did a lot of, like, pages in comics and anthologies and stuff for people.
Yeah.
And those always paid off, because they're always filled with great artists. But there is the risk that you could do one and it doesn't sell, you don't get paid.
Mm.
Especially if they're like, you'll get a percentage.
Mm.
I think stay clear of that where possible. So I've just done Helen's hair. It is not the shape in the picture. I've just changed it completely.
That looks pretty.
You look like young Marge.
young Marge Simpson. I guess I am taking a risk currently, because yeah. I'm starting out on this adventure of trying to turn my art into income.
Yeah.
So getting the zines printed, I feel is a risk, because, you know, there's always the chance that even though people might like your paintings, they might not be interested in seeing them as a zine, or they just might not want to buy the zine.
Yeah.
So it's quite scary.
Yeah, and you left your job.
Yeah, and I left my job.
Which is
scary. So there's that too. That's quite, you know, that's always...
But that is a risk. I'm very glad you did, by the way.
Yeah, same.
It was having a terrible effect on your mental health.
Oh, it was. So it was a risk, and it was leaving my job. It was something that I had been considering for months and months and months.
Yeah, you didn't just...
I didn't just decide, like, yeah. one morning, oh, I'm going to leave my job. It's something that I considered for a while.
Yeah.
And I knew it was making me ill, and I knew I was so much happier painting that I decided to, after much thought, it would be better for me to leave and try and pursue this.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And get the fear.
Yeah, the fear. The constant fear.
Like on Friends?
Yeah, on Chandler and Rachel.
Yeah.
I had to get the fear.
You gotta get the fear. If you're too comfortable, you won't make changes.
Yeah.
Although I don't think your job made you comfortable.
No, not at all.
I think it did the opposite.
It really...
But it can make you complacent though, right?
Mm.
Yeah, because it was, you know, you just go in and you get your money and
leave. You think this is the rest of it. This is just life now.
Mm-hmm. It got to a point where I just couldn't believe that this could be my life.
Yeah. And that was kind of sad when you said that, or when you were experiencing that as well. So it's tough as well as a friend being like, you should leave your one source of income,
I think. It's really hard,
and take this massive risk. It's kind of like, well, you should, but can I say that?
Because in the past, I'd never tried to try and turn this into something. And I was always too scared to, because I was scared of failure.
Mm. Yeah.
But I think I'd be so much more disappointed if I didn't try at all.
Yeah.
It's recording.
Welcome back, y'all.
Welcome back, Lize.
Hey!
Oh, hi!
Where did you go?
I went to turn the camera on.
So, yeah, if you've never seen my art before, hi. But I can't draw noses, so I just paint, like, cowboy boot shapes. And it's sort of, it's like getting into a style hole. Because I can't draw a nose now. That would go against the grain. And people would be like, what is she doing?
What's happened?
So I just roll with it and make it work.
Yeah, that's cool. I haven't tried to draw a person like this in many a year.
It's tough, right?
It's really hard.
I can't draw realistic.
And I'm not wearing my glasses. And I really should be. This is what I've got so far of Nathan. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was thinking about me. I was thinking about me thinking about Lize. So here are some prelim sketches that I drew of Ms. Meddings. And this is the sketch that I'm working on now. It's not there yet. Still cooking. Still cooking.
I'm trying to do shadows on this picture with no shadows.
Sweet. Improvise those shadows.
Okay.
I haven't drawn any hair on you just yet, Lize. It's quite fun.
This is Lize on your hair.
Oh, it's so cute. It's really good.
Yeah.
I have quite a round head.
A round head?
Yeah. A round face. But I'm okay with round. Whatever.
This picture is great.
Oh, so good.
That looks like if Nathan was in a band.
Yeah.
It's the grunge hair.
I love it. This is my next.
If I could play guitar.
Chosen picture.
Oh my god, you're doing more than one?
You bet. This if is you, happening.
If you watched last week's episode, Helen didn't even meet the criteria.
I thought I'd go my own way.
Sketchbook Club.
I thought I'd go my own way. Follow your own voice, right? She took a risk.
I took a risk.
She did take a risk. Much to my dismay.
Yeah.
So well done. I'm impressed.
Oh, thanks.
Nathan, what are some more archie-based risks? Because you talked about leaving your job.
Risk.
And that's a big risk.
Okay.
But in your art career?
I think not so much, not quite a risk, but interning here maybe?
Oh, yeah.
That was really a risk.
But it could have been.
It could have been a risk.
Yeah.
How, though?
Because, well, Nathan interned here for 2 months for free. He offered to help us out before Christmas. So then we hired him. But we could have not hired you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that could have been sad.
Yeah, that would have been a risk.
Yeah, putting yourself out there maybe is a risk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And also, like, I could have just said no.
Yeah, my ego could have been, like, smashed on the door.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I didn't say no, obviously.
How could you say no
well,
to that face?
If someone wants to help out over Christmas for a small business, you can't say no to that.
Mm.
So it was good timing, Nathan.
Yeah, I picked it. Should we do the best risk that you guys have taken?
Moving here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
To Bristol.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I moved here with my partner Rob nearly 3 years ago. And before that I was living in Plymouth after graduating. That's when I was a cleaner and having the worst time of my life. But then moved home for 6 months. So that, and that was actually when I got most of my like big illustration jobs.
Yeah.
Like I got commissioned the most, and I painted a big fish that I got paid for as well, and it was kind of like, oh, this is the beginning.
I'm doing it.
And then moved to Bristol.
I'm glad you moved to Bristol.
Oh, me too.
I'm super glad about that.
I'm really glad as well that I had the 6 months at home, because it meant as well we could like readjust where we wanted to go, what we wanted to do, and save as well, because we were both living at home, which really helped. We moved here, neither of us having a job. Me saying that I wasn't going to get one. I was just going to work freelance. And Rob was just cool with it, which was good. But then, like, Sad Ghost Club happened. And if we'd moved here, it wouldn't be my job anymore.
Mm.
No way.
Yeah.
Being in a city has really helped, not just because Laura was here. But just like we can conduct workshops here and stuff, and I'm not just in the middle of Devon, stuck.
Yeah.
It did suck though when we moved, because we were both, Rob was employed back in Devon, but I wasn't. But we had to pay 6 months rent up front.
Really?
Yeah, because neither of us had like a job here.
Oh.
So that sucked. And that made it one hell of a risk.
Yeah,
because we thought, also, we didn't know if Rob would end up with job, because he didn't know what he wanted to do.
Yeah.
So we thought we might just burn all our savings, have paid 6 months here and then have to go home. But we didn't, thankfully.
It worked out. I think even putting your work out there is a risk. Yeah.
You know, thinking about it. Because it's hard as well with the, like, social media presence and the way your work comes across, like, how people are going to...
perceive it.
Yeah, and what they're going to take from it and your personality.
Yeah.
When I first finished uni and was making lots of illustration work, it was all pretty edgy. And there were a lot of swear words, and just meant people thought I was a lot cooler than I was. So I'd go to like art fairs and stuff, and people would just be disappointed that I was just a polite, friendly person.
Hey.
Like, hello!
The edge.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I was going to use watercolours, and I wanted to show you my watercolour palette that I've had since I was 16.
Aww.
So it's very well loved. This is all acrylic, so it won't come out. But it's great because you can replace the palettes.
Mm.
I love these ones. That's why it's lasted me so long.
Handy little carry case.
Yeah, it's so good. Like, I've moved a lot and I've thrown out a lot of stuff, but I've kept that.
Yeah.
It's my friend.
Mm-hmm.
Your friend.
Yeah, that's what it feels like. I don't know whether to do your eyes red.
Yeah. Go on, I dare ya. Take a risk.
I'm gonna take a risk.
Sketchbooks are good because they are good for taking risks.
Oh yeah, definitely. I remembered what you said in one of the other videos, Nathan, about how sketchbooks should be like for playing and experimenting more.
Yeah.
But like, if I do a page I don't like, I will cut it out.
Oh no.
So last night I was just painting some animal shapes and having fun. I was having a good time.
Good.
Yeah.
Just enjoying the moment.
Yeah. Oh, the eyes stress me out. Don't know if I'm ready yet. I've got shaky coffee hands.
I believe in you.
No, I'm going to do your eye circles red and then the outline blue.
Cool. So you're turning me into some kind of mythical
demonic
creature.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah? Good.
Yeah, I wish I actually looked like that. That would be pretty cool.
No, well, that's great.
I feel like I should definitely practice more with drawing like this.
It's tough. It's easy to forget, isn't it, when you paint all the time?
It is. And it's easy to forget when you are out of uni or college and you've stopped doing life drawing.
Yeah.
As a consistent practice.
Yeah.
You get quite skilled, quite good at drawing people. And when you stop doing it for so long, you kind of forget.
Speaking of, the place where we have our studio. Yeah, you go,
yeah.
You go.
Oh, yeah.
News.
News. Do, 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 do. So, at the island where our new studio is based, there's, they host many different events, but they do life drawing, and they do, like, circus life drawing.
What?
So they go up in the silks and do, like, poses and with hula hoops.
Yeah.
Hula hoops? Is that the...
I'm not circus savvy.
Neither.
Circus hoops.
That sounds
and
incredible. Oh, man, we have to do that.
Yeah. She was saying as well that, like, it's not tutor-led, which is kind of good.
Mm.
That kind of appeals. I don't like people telling me what to do. So you just go and, like, you've got the poses.
That's so cool. I think I might add some pen to this.
Yeah? Oh, that looks more like Nate.
This is a lot better than the first attempt.
I see it.
Do you see it?
I see it.
So this is a second attempt I did of Nathan. I think it's slightly... looks slightly more like him. That was just a warm-up.
Yeah, that's why we warm up, guys.
I just did 20 warm-ups.
Your hair looks so lovely.
Thank you.
So, I took a risk at the weekend. I bought a very expensive ticket to see Russell Brand.
Russell Brand's touring?
Yeah, he's touring again. So I've got a ticket for May.
and that was expensive.
Can that pay off?
what makes that a risk?
Because I have no money. But it's good because it means you have to sell some art.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's like digging yourself in a hole.
And I took a risk also because I bought one ticket for myself. And I've never gone to an event or a show on my own before.
Oh,
and I thought, this would be a nice treat.
Yeah.
Because I've been following Russell Brand since I was about 16.
Oh.
So I've been consistent fan. So when I found out he was touring again, I was just like, went straight online.
Can't say no.
Yeah.
No, it's good. And I think it will prompt you to try and make the ticket back. I think it's pretty good for you. Okay, so I've just painted Helen's jumper, which I'm maybe going to add a pattern to.
Nice.
I need to do the eyes, but I'm scared.
Why are you scared?
Because it's easy to do one, it's hard to do the other.
Yeah, that's true.
But we'll see how it goes. Just got to try it, right?
Exactly.
After drawing Lies 30,000 times,
that's so famous.
I've decided that I like this one, so I'm going to redraw.
Yeah.
Redraw.
Good half-ish shape.
And hopefully ink by the end of this video.
They have so much movement.
Yeah.
It's really nice. I've just been adding some fine liner to the bottom drawing of Nathan.
Which is good. Looks like Nathan.
Yeah.
Moody Nathan.
It's a very moody Nathan.
If you ever release an EP, I think Helen needs to draw that picture for the cover.
Yeah.
That's what it looks like. Okay. Second eye.
You can do it.
It's like doing your own eyeliner. That's what it feels like.
Just psych yourself up.
Yeah. Don't you? I always have to take a break in between them.
Just have a breather.
Yeah, that was intense. Time for number two. I had to put the hat in, obviously.
Which I've stopped wearing recently.
How come?
Did you fall out?
Me and the hat, we had an argument.
Oof.
I just feel like I overwore it. Cool information. cool.
There's no such thing as overwearing a
hat. Not when it's a great hat like that.
Yeah.
It's a hat on a hat.
Thanks, Natalie.
How's it going?
Well.
How you doing? Are you going to fit in another one?
Doing some lines.
Or not?
I don't know. I think I'm just quite enjoying concentrating on this one.
Yeah.
For the time being.
Making it the best it can be.
Exactly.
All the meat can be.
Yeah. I kind of would like to have that painting.
You can totally have it.
Really?
Yeah.
That's nice of you. Thanks. Oh.
You can have this drawing Lies.
Sweet, thanks.
Especially because it's in your sketchbook.
Well.
Thank you.
Lies painted me a really great painting for my birthday once, and it was a manatee, and it had a speech bubble, and it just said, "You can do the thing." That was a really nice painting.
Oh, I'm glad you liked it.
Yeah.
I knew it was for Helen's birthday last year.
Yeah.
So, a year ago, we hadn't known each other that long, maybe like 6 months.
Yeah, something like that.
And I knew I wanted to paint her a painting, and you were having a hard time. So I wanted to try and motivate you. I mean, it worked, because you've made a zine now.
Yes.
So thanks, Manatee.
And Lize knew that I quite liked manatees.
I did not. I messaged Laura.
Did Laura tell you? Helen likes manatees.
I was literally like, I want to draw an animal. What's her favourite? And I was like, it could be a pug. And that felt like, I don't know.
I do love
a projection.
Pugs.
Yeah.
Like, I think she likes pugs.
Yeah. And that felt too obvious.
You need something different.
So I think she told me ducks and manatees. I was like, okay, I can do a manatee.
Manatees are great creatures, aren't they?
Yeah.
Sea cows.
Why are they called sea cows? You knew this?
Because they're the cows of the sea.
Yeah. Because they look a bit like...
What, people steal their milk as well? What does that mean?
They just are big old
sea cows.
Just thinking about them makes me feel happy.
Oh. So that painting's helped you?
Yeah. You betcha.
Sweet. That was the intent. Mm.
My other friend Anne, she was in one of the episodes of Sketchbook Club Online, painted me a picture of a cat. Like, do you remember that?
It's yeah.
Like a big cat face. And on the back she wrote, dogs rule, cats drool. She doesn't like cats, but she knows I love cats. And I would say, I think I love cats and dogs equally. I'm not a cat or
diplomatic.
I love them both. What do you think?
I used to be a cat person.
I'm neither.
Oh, fair.
Where is your soul, Nathan?
Buried. Deep in the back garden.
Yeah, I used to be just cats, but then my parents got a dog. And then I was a dog person.
Whatever will be cute.
Yeah.
Kind of person.
They both have their strengths.
Yeah. I love cats for the character. Mm. And it feels like a cat owns you.
Yeah.
You don't own the cat. You just share.
They kind of just do their own
combination. Yeah. Dogs are needy. But that's why they're great.
Yeah, exactly. It's tough, isn't it?
Yeah.
My brother's cat likes to knock pennies off the side of things. You can pennies. You can just line up a row of pennies and he'll jump up and just slowly knock them all off one by one.
What about dominoes? Does he like dominoes?
He would probably love dominoes.
What about dominoes?
Yeah.
I think, because I watch quite a lot of animal YouTube videos when I need cheering up, and I think I prefer dog videos to cats. So does that make me a dog person over a cat person?
It make you happier.
Yeah, dogs just are sillier, aren't they?
Yeah, they are silly and stupid.
Yeah. I think, you know, for a first pet, when I finally can get a pet, I would like to adopt a dog.
Yeah.
As the first.
You can just chill. Yeah, me too. And also, if you can look after a dog, then you can look after a cat.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
I'm going to ink you now, Lize.
Cool. I just painted Helen's lips.
Ooh.
Very delicate.
It's funny how you say that you like my mouth, because I really dislike it.
No, it's ooh, cute.
Talk me through this.
I just find that I just have uneven lips, especially my top lip.
No, and you've got this little bit?
No.
Yeah.
And I think they're really thin. I don't like that. But hey, what are you going to do?
Well, I think they're great.
Me too.
And they're good to draw.
Thanks, everybody.
Although I'm kind of messing it up.
You're good to draw as well, Lize. I drew you like a billion times.
Sweet.
So we're officially friends now. We're drawing each other.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when do you know that you're officially a friend with someone?
Nathan, did we have this chat? I had this chat with somebody.
We had this.
For me, it's when...
You invited me around for the first
time. Yeah, it's either when they come to your house or you go to theirs. Mm. Just like when you're a child and you go to the tea.
Or if you... I always find that you kind of know that you're a friend if you invite them to hang out with you just kind of one-on-one.
Oh yeah, that's big.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. If you are going into town or something, like getting lunch, I feel like that's when you know that you're a friend. Like a friendship date.
Yeah, actually, one of our trips into town was when I felt like you were my friend. Not just Laura's friend.
Yeah.
You know, because like... When there's three of you as well.
Or somebody else's friend.
Yeah, it can be hard. And because you and Laura have known each other for so long, it's like, oh, well, she's Laura's friend.
But then we went by ourselves.
It's quite nerve-wracking.
No.
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was great.
But no, I wanted to impress you.
What did you do? Handstands?
I did 20 backflips.
Yeah.
And I was like, this girl is cool.
Yeah, no. I thought it was nice.
What did we even do? We go shopping.
Mm-hmm. Helen loves to shop and I hate to shop, so...
You hate to shop?
Yeah, I hate shopping. Oh my God. I don't have the time or the patience, especially clothes shopping. So if I do go, I have to take Helen with me. Because annoyingly, people need clothes.
Yeah.
Which sucks. You have to be my like personal shopper for the day.
It's funny because I actually used to be a personal shopper.
It's great.
In House of Fraser.
Yeah, you're very diplomatic.
For a while.
She's like, well, if you like it, you should get it. No, it's cute. And yeah, I can't waste my shopping. I have to do it when you're there. Else I feel like she's missed out.
I get really excited when I go shopping with friends. And I can't really go shopping much anymore because I have no money.
Because you left your job.
Exactly.
Risky.
So when the time arises, if someone invites me to go shopping, I'm all for it. Because I get that kind of buyer's high when someone else has bought stuff as well.
I'm not sure. Therapy.
Yeah, even if it's not for me. So if we went shopping and you bought stuff, I'd just get really excited.
We should go shopping.
Cool, thanks guys. Friendship.
You can come too. We're not friends. You can come too.
No, I hate shopping.
Oh. That's fine.
Okay, so this is how my Helen's looking. I'm pleased with the painting. I don't think it's a picture of Helen so much.
Oh my God, I love the hat!
That's cute, right?
The hat looks so good!
The only thing is that I think that eyes are upside down because on her picture you can't really see them, so I was going by memory. It looks a bit like it's in your head.
Yeah!
That's okay.
I'm cool with that.
Like a slow king.
Yes. Exactly like a slow king.
If you were a Pokemon, Lize, what Pokemon would you be?
Can you say it about yourself?
I don't know. Which Pokemon would you like to be? And which Pokemon do you think you objectively would be?
Oh, tough. I don't know.
Come on, do you have an answer?
All I can think of is my favourites.
Okay.
So my favourite Pokemon is Noivern.
Which one's Noivern?
He evolves from Noibat, the big later generation bat.
I don't know any new
Pokemon. And
he's
like blue and purple. And he looks so good.
Mm.
And he has big ears.
I think he'd make a good Eevee.
Adaptable. I'm not adaptable, I hate change.
But it looks so cute.
Yeah, but that's not the criteria.
Oh, I'm sorry.
If anything, you'd be an Eevee because you're shorter than me. Be a little Eevee put in your pocket.
Pocket Eevee?
Yeah. Oh, I want one. Oh, boy. It was the greatest injustice as a kid that Pokemon weren't real. It just sucked.
Like Santa Claus or Pokemon? Pokemon.
Oh, yeah, of course.
What Pokemon would you want to be?
What would I want to be?
Yeah.
See, that's different to what you think you are.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think I really liked Roselia.
Mm-hmm.
Loved Roselia.
Yeah, I could see you as Roselia.
But I think I'd really like to be, I think maybe Prima Marina?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we've got that in common.
Oh, I don't know any of these Pokemon.
It's the new gen.
Yeah, I don't know them.
What about you, Helen?
Psyduck, because Psyduck gets a lot of headaches.
No, I see that.
So...
That's really good.
I think that makes sense.
Yeah.
I get a lot of headaches.
Is Psyduck who you'd want to be also?
No. I don't want to live that headache life.
Yeah.
I see you as, like, Haunter, maybe? Because Haunter's cute, but also mischievous.
Yeah.
But, like, adorable, so what are you going to do?
I need to see a picture of this Pokemon.
Haunter. Ghastly, Haunter, and Gengar.
Oh, he's the middle one.
The spiky one. With the tongue. Or the all with the tongue, right?
This one.
Oh. I thought you were going to, like, pick a really girly one.
I don't know, what are the girly Pokemon that you know? Like, first gen ones?
Clefairy. Yeah.
I think you're a bit too edgy to be Clefairy.
Jigglypuff.
Oh, yeah, Jigglypuff. It's kind of you. Haunter is just, like, hard to catch.
But I'm so slow. I'd probably be well easy to catch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm the slowest walker in town.
True.
That looks amazing.
Thank you.
Such good lines.
Does it look like me? I quite like not sitting near, actually. So you can do the big reveal.
Yeah, there'll be a...
Like I've paid for it.
You kind of did.
Yeah, true.
Inadvertently. I think I'm done.
Yeah? Well, I'm nearly done.
Wait.
Okay.
I'm just gonna work out the lines.
How about you, Helen?
Hmm?
You actually did the thing.
I did the thing. I did what we set out to do. And I didn't ignore it.
Better than last
I actually
week.
Did it.
Well done. Proud of you.
Good, thanks.
How do you feel?
Feel alright, you know.
Accomplished?
Yeah.
Because you did it?
I feel...
Proud?
Yeah, I do feel a little bit proud. Do you feel proud?
Yeah, I was stuck at the beginning and didn't think that it was going to come together, and it did. It just kept on keeping on.
Yeah,
kept on keeping on.
How about you? How do you feel about it?
Yeah, good. I don't like the underline. It makes you look a little bit more goth than you are.
Mm.
But what are you going to do? You're just going to have to live with it, haven't you?
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Cool. Thanks. And I didn't get around to patterning your jumper, but that is
never mind.
A-okay. And yeah, I'm quite pleased with the shadows, actually, considering there were none on your photo.
Pure filter. Filtered light.
How far? Oh my god.
It's not bad. You did a really good job there.
Thanks, I think you did an excellent job.
Thank you.
Look at Moody Nathan.
Such mood.
Oh, shall we hold him up with the photos? Although, Nathan was drawing from a photo. But this is the comparison. It's hard with stylized work, though. I think I just took elements like your hair and hat.
That hat.
Yeah. Golden hat. Let me see, Nate. Show me.
This is my interpretation of your face.
So good.
Yeah. It's beautiful.
Sweet brows.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Excellent. It's like a caricature.
It is. A caricature.
I like it a lot.
This is a side-by-side comparison.
Oh yes, have a look. I really like
what
this one.
What do you
one.
Think? Oh, that's good. it's a bit cheeky,
can
isn't it?
Can you show it?
I feel like some of them were getting far away from who you are.
The bottom one. Oh, it's so good. That's like me when I asked Rob to cook.
Rib. Will you make dinner?
I've done like a few pages of you.
Yeah.
You look like I'm so somebody special. Who's obsessed with you.
Oh, that's okay.
I am.
Nice. So is this where you started off?
Man, started these this are one. So much better than those. Yeah.
Sorry, but
no.
You progressed so well.
Yeah.
It's really good.
So it goes, this is my first page. So I start with some pretty bad drawings.
Eyeliner is good for drawing people, right?
Yeah.
It's good for... I always draw my ladies with eyeliner.
Like, I had to get out, like, I had to try and nail down your face shapes.
Round.
No, not at all, though. Because, like, look at the curves and the swerves.
Yeah, it's pretty.
Yeah, and that's how it happened.
It's really good. Mm. It's great seeing the process.
Yeah.
It's
So that's it.
That is it
for this week.
Until next week.
Indeed.
We're not sure what next week's theme will be, so let us know any ideas that you have. And yeah, we're gonna think about possibly live streaming our sketching. Which we haven't started yet, but we'd love to know if that's like a thing that you would tune into, just through Instagram or something.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So people can comment and ask questions, and then we'll put up the edited version like these videos. So these will stay the same and stay weekly, but the actual us drawing now, we're thinking about live streaming. So yeah.
That's the end.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks for joining in.
Yeah.
And draw your friends.
Yeah.
And compliment your friends.
Yeah.
Tell them that they're nice.
Yeah.
Take a risk.
Yeah. Take some risks.
Cool. Bye.
Bye.